Hello everyone. In this video, we'll discuss how array indexing is done in NumPy. Okay. So if you are clear with the basic list, okay, this is very easy. Array indexing is very easy. So basically, like list, okay, like list, the first index, okay, for array, the first index is 0, okay, next index it is 1, like this it goes, okay. So here for this example, A is some array created, it contains elements 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay. So if I want to access the first element, so A square bracket, then the index C, that will give 1. Okay. If I want first one, I need to give A1. Okay. That will give 2. Okay, that will give 2. Similarly, I can do other operations like print A2 plus A3. Okay, so this is 0, 1, 2 and 3. A of 2 is 3. A of 3 is 4. So, it will add 3 and 4 and it will give the result 7. Okay. These are simple examples, so I am not going for NumPy directly, I am just explaining these things here. Okay. So, one dimensional array, it is no problem. What about the two dimensional arrays? How you will access the elements of two dimensional arrays? Say for example, here I created an array, two dimensional array, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then outside a big bracket. Okay, two dimensional array like a matrix. Okay, so here I'm just printing C 0, 1. The first one 0. If you see this two dimensional array, there are two one dimensional arrays. Okay, so the index of the first one dimensional array is 0, second one dimensional array is 1. So the first 0, it tells that, okay, I am going to access a element from this one dimensional array. Then the next 1, it says that in that, if you see, there are 3 elements with index 0, 1 and 2. I am going to access the element with index 1, which is 2. Okay. Say for example, if it is C of 1, 2. 1 means this particular one dimensional array, in that 0, 1, 2, I am going to access 6. Okay, I am going to access 6. Then, to access elements from 3D arrays, again, okay, let me introduce a 3 dimensional array. 3 dimensional array means it should have elements as 2 dimensional arrays. So, let me take some 3 dimensional array. Okay, first 1, 2, 3, this is one one dimensional array, 4, 0, 1, this is another one dimensional array, 3, 4, 1, another one dimensional array, 2, 2, 3. So what I'm doing, I'm just okay making a 2D array here also another 2D array. Okay, and with these 2D arrays I'm just creating another array, that is a 3 dimensional array. Now to access, this is D, okay, to access, I want to access D, 0, 1, comma, 0, okay, what is that, we'll see. So, it has 2 two dimensional arrays. Okay, two dimensional arrays. It has totally two dimensional arrays. First one is 0 index, second two dimensional array index is 1. So this 0 indicates that I am going to consider this particular two dimensional array. Then in that, two 1 dimensional arrays are there. Okay, this is 0, 1. So this 1 indicates that I am not going to consider this, I am going to consider this. Okay, 4, 0, 1. Then the third one in that 0th index. Okay, 4. So it displays 4. Similarly, D 0, 0, 2. Okay, 0 means this particular 2 dimensional array. Again, 0 means this particular one in that 2, 0, 1, 2. It displays 3. Okay, like that we will go for other examples. D 1, 0, 1. 101. 1 means this one, 0 means this one, 1 means 4. Okay, it gives 4. 110. 110. 1 means this one, 1 means this one, 0, 2. Okay, 002. So, 0, this particular 2 dimensional array, 0 in that 2, 3. Okay, list, we also have the negative indexing. Okay, say I have a array 1, 2, 3, 4, these are the items. Okay, positive indexing 0, 1, 2 and 3, negative indexing, the last element is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. If I print A of minus 2, it prints 3. Okay, it prints 3. Then suppose I have a 2 dimensional array. Okay, 1, 2, 3, comma 4, 5, 6. Okay, this is the 2 dimensional array. Let me call this as C. I want to access C of minus 2, comma minus 1. So this is index minus 1, this is minus 2. Okay, minus 1, minus 2. So, minus 2, first one means, so this particular one dimensional array. In that minus 1, okay, this is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So, this element, 3. Okay, then C of minus 1, comma minus 2. Minus 1, comma minus 2. Minus 1 means this particular one dimensional array in that minus 2, minus 1, minus 2, 5. Okay, then I have here 3 dimensional array. So let me write the 3 dimensional array 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 1, 3, 4, 1, 2, 2, 3. Okay, 2, 2, 3. With this 2, I am just making a 2 dimensional array, this 2 I am making a 2 dimensional array, with these 2 2 dimensional arrays I am just making a 3 dimensional array. Okay, so I want to access D of minus 2, minus 1, minus 2. There are 2 2 dimensional arrays are available. Okay, so this is 1 2 dimensional array, this is another 2 dimensional array, minus 1, minus 2. Okay, there are 2 2 dimensional arrays. So this minus 2 indicates that I am going to take this particular 2 dimensional array. In that there are 2 things, minus 1, minus 2. Okay, I am going to consider this particular one. In that minus 2, minus 1, minus 2 is 0. Then D of minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So minus 1, this particular one, in that minus 2, minus 1, minus 2, this is minus 2, in that minus 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, it's 3. Okay, so in this video we have discussed the array indexing, both positive indexing and negative indexing. Okay, I'll stop here. Thank you.